My name is Vivan, and today I'm going to talk about the Mughal dynasty, its fathers and their sons. Once upon a time, there lived a mighty king named Timur Ilang. He owned a tiny kingdom. One day he was killed in battle. He had a son named Abu Shaikh Mirza. Abu Shaikh Mirza took that small kingdom, but expanded the vast. He ruled for a long time, but one day he died. His son, Umar Shaikh Mirza, began to rule, but they lost so many lands and became such a small kingdom. At the end, he only had one tiny kingdom called Ferghana. There were mighty mountains on top of Andijan, where he loved playing with in his dove cut. In his dove cut, there were many pigeons to feed. And his wife gave birth to a baby boy named Babur. Babur was a great ruler. He forced to rule when he was 12. He kept ruling and he invaded India after fighting Sultan Ibrahim Lodi. After that, he bore a son named Humayun. Humayun was a weak ruler but struggled hard to keep India. He had a son named Akbar the Great. Yes, you heard that right. It's Akbar the Great. Akbar the Great was a brave ruler. He had a commander named Bairam Khan, and he had a brave soldier named Shams-ud-Din. And Shams-ud-Din's wife was his nurse, Mahamagni, who saved his life when he was small. When Babur's other sons named Kamran, Askari and Hindal began to attack Akbar because they hated his father and conspired against him. But Mahamagni saved him. So, they had a long battle. Bairam was banished, and Mahamagni's son Adam Khan had become the chief minister. But soon, Akbar executed him for killing his other minister. In all this time, his wife had a baby named Jahangir, also known as Salim and Shaikhu Baba in his young age. He grew up to be a brave warrior. Soon Akbar had died. Jahangir ascended the mighty throne of the Mughals. Then they began to attack places like Mewar and places like small kingdoms, which attacked them and didn't let them rule like Rana Sangha ruling Mewar. So then he bore a son named Khusrau Parvez, and finally after his wife gave birth to a son named Shah Jahan and his military training started, they had a son named Shahryar. Shahryar wanted to become king, but Shah Jahan defeated him. Shah Jahan and his wife had 14 sons. His third son, Aurangzeb, became king. He was a brave warrior too, but when he was old, he was captured by Bahadur Shah, who also became known as Bahadur Shah of Gujarat, and he was captured. The end.